Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of our Farming RPG tutorial series. From the previous part, there is a bug in which the entire tool section of the inventory failed to work. The inventory slot prefab somehow got reset while we were doing the TextMesh Pro migration. So to fix it, simply set the inventory type to tool for all the inventory slots under tools. Since we have the goal of bringing marriage into the game, the most important mechanic we have to deal with is the handling of NPC events. Let's say we have a class that handles all the NPC events, and the event triggers only need to look out for the number of hearts in a given NPC, and the location of the player. In that case, the NPC event controller only needs to check relationship stats and scene transition manager to see if the conditions are met. But what if we have events that have more specific conditions? Are we going to hard code every condition under the sun? It would simply not be scalable. So instead of having to look everywhere, we will implement a Blackboard, which is a shared data source that has all the information that we need for events to work. So we made a new class, GameBlackboard, which comprises of a dictionary, taking in a key and an object. This object can be anything, an int, boolean, string, or even the classes that we made. To make things type safe, we added functions to handle the getting and setting of these values and ensured that the types match. The other classes will access this blackboard through GameStateManager. At first, I thought of having the key be an enum, so that way the lookup would be faster. However, once I started refactoring the code for animal stats, I realized that it would be better to stick with strings instead. In future, we might optimize this with hashing, but for now, the strings are sufficient. We had some constants at the top so we don't lose track of the naming convention, and got to work. In the animal creation process, we had it track the total number of animals and animal data by index number. Then I changed the way the game saved by removing the animal component in a game save state and have the blackboard be in it instead. Saving the blackboard directly like this will give us more flexibility in what we want to put in. We might have to revisit this arrangement in future if our project gets bigger. I rewrote the save and load logic for the animals in relationship save state. Testing it, I realized that we missed changing the input field for our naming prompt to TextMesh Pro, so I fixed that real quick. On the surface, nothing has changed, but we have successfully migrated our animal data over to the blackboard. Now we do the same for the human NPCs. We have to rewrite the helper functions to use the blackboard, especially when a new character is unlocked, or if there is a change in the value of a relationship. To make it easier to work with lists, I added a get function for list types in game Blackboard. In part 22, we had some feedback that the eggs were disappearing once the player left the chicken coop. To fix that, we need to make a game object not despawn immediately after we leave the scene. We need to have a way to save it and instantiate them again once the player returns. With a blackboard, we can easily do so by keeping a list of each scene that tracks the game object and its position in the world space. We made our own instantiate and destroy functions in Game State Manager, which will update the blackboard accordingly. Over in Chicken Behavior, when the chicken lays an egg, we call this persistent instantiate function. Then on the interactable object, we have the item call persistent destroy instead, to have it taken out from the list. And then after playtesting it, I realized that there will be a serialization issue, that when we save it in the main blackboard. So I created a separate board, Scene Items Board, to track these items in Game State Manager. And then we see that this blackboard is not only useful for hard events, but it can have other uses, and it will be used by other things, such as tracking down everything that you want to track to give player their achievements. The most obvious one would be shipping. So let's implement the blackboard for shipping. I made it keep track of every item that is shipped and its quantities in a list in a shipping bin class, as well as the integer of the total items shipped. And that's what we have for this part. In the coming parts, we will get to implementing our events and all the uses that we have for the blackboard. We probably have to refactor some more code. So stay tuned and wait for the next part. We'll see you then.